This is my 12th swearing-in ceremony, and like my very first one, we are here on New Year's Day. Now, in some respects, that makes it a little more difficult, and it takes for some extra preparation, but I think it makes it more special. We begin our work, our day, on day one of the new year, and I'm sure it will be an auspicious beginning for all of us. And to our family members, friends, and guests who have joined us here today, welcome to this historic House of Representatives. And you know, this is a perfect time when we have our family and friends with us here today to say thank you. Thank you for all the hardships that you have endured. For each of us who serves in this House, our families also serve with us. And we all know it's not easy. They share in our success, but they also must make sacrifices because of the job that we hold. It may not be well understood by outside observers, but it is something that each of us face every day. None of us would be here or could continue to serve here without the love and support of our families. So thank you all very much. The members of this House come from different places and different backgrounds. Each of you, Republican and Democrat, has a story to tell about how you made a decision to run for office, won a tough campaign, and arrived here today. But the majority and minority do not have to be two parties constantly at odds. We are two parts together, and we make up one House. Even today, Speaker Smith was sitting right here with some Democrats. And as I look over there, I see other Republicans sitting with some Democrats. So we're trying to do something about that. But it shows us, it's clearly we meet and conduct the people's business collectively before the eyes and the ears of the people of Pennsylvania. We will do well to remember that we are one House with one mission, to best serve the people of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. And I think the events of this week in Washington offer a very real lesson of what is at stake when government does not perform at its best. We see what can happen when ideological extremism gets in the way of common sense. I have gotten to know many of you over time, and I have a great deal of respect for anyone who steps forward in the spirit of public service. While we may disagree on matters of legislation and policy, we are united in our love of this state and concern for the people we represent. We share a goal to make Pennsylvania a better place. Part of the strength of our House is the mix between experienced members with years of knowledge about the state and the issues that we face, and the newer members who bring fresh ideas and energy. Every new session brings new vitality to this House, and this year, with 29 new members, 19 of them members of the Democratic Caucus, this House will be a better place because of all this new energy and drive. We're looking forward to the opportunity to work with each and every one of you. Now, without getting too far into the details of policy, I will note, and I think any casual observer will note, that the Democrats in this House disagreed with many decisions that were made in Pennsylvania over the last 2 years. We would have liked to have seen more investment in education, transportation, health care, the environment. We believe in making smart investments that raise the standard of living for all Pennsylvanians and contribute to the growth of businesses and other institutions that create jobs for working families. The members of this House, as elected representatives and leaders in Pennsylvania government, need to take on the real problems that Pennsylvanians face. We need to understand that our workers, our family, and our children are our top priority. Let's make sure that workers' jobs are protected, children's schools are adequately staffed, and quality health care remains available, affordable, and accessible to all Pennsylvanians. We know this is not easy. We all recognize the economic reality confronting our state and our nation. Our challenge is to find ways to balance the state budget, as we are required to do, while keeping in place essential services to the people who need those services. It is no easy task, to be sure, but we must succeed in this work if Pennsylvania is to move forward. So, on New Year's Day, we should resolve as one House to move Pennsylvania forward to a better place. Let's work together to improve our schools and universities that our children attend. Reducing support for education is not a sound strategy for future success. Let us work together to protect the environmental treasures that Pennsylvania is blessed with, our rivers, our forests, mountains, and rich agricultural areas. Let us work together to preserve Pennsylvania's national leadership in healthcare delivery and research so that the people of our state can live longer and healthier lives. Let us work together, as we have many times before, to make this state a better place to do business and to put people in jobs, to work in jobs that pay family-sustaining wages. And let us work together to keep the safety net in place for the most vulnerable Pennsylvanians. The members of the Democratic Caucus stand ready to do this job. We look forward to working with all of our colleagues in the House and Senate to achieve these goals. The challenges facing our state are real ones and will not be solved by political infighting or partisan ideological approaches. We will all do better if we try to find common ground and common purpose. The problems facing our Commonwealth are as serious as they have ever been, and the people of Pennsylvania need us to be at our best. Today is a very happy and festive occasion, as it should be, but there are serious things that we have to do in the upcoming months, and our work begins today. To the Democratic Caucus, I just want to say thank you. It is truly an honor and it's very humbling to be your leader. I promise you I will do my best. And to everyone here today and to the people of Pennsylvania, I wish you all a happy new year, and I wish you the best wishes for a happy, healthy, and prosperous 2013. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Speaker, thanks, the gentleman.